those of you who don't know, I am a career and leadership coach, and I spent 20 years in corporate America and just leapt out into coaching in 2019. And so when I leapt out into coaching, I was just doing kind of generic leadership coaching. So I was coaching both men and women, and companies would either hire me to come speak and lead training, or they would hire me to coach their leaders, both men and women. And I knew that in 2020, I wanted to make a shift to start focusing more on women. In fact, my word of the year was align. I'm like, okay, I need to align my business, and I want to eventually stop coaching both men and women in corporate and just focus on women and help women advance, help them advance to the rooms where decisions are made, help them make brave career changes. But in my mind, I was like, oh, I'm totally gonna have like 2 years to make this transition. I'll just kind of slowly, you know, say goodbye to my corporate coaching of both men and women, my generic coaching, and I'll eventually just scale my business to grow to be just women. And then COVID hit. So literally in a period of, it felt like overnight, but I'm not joking, in probably a period of 10 days, I lost 80 to 90% of my annual income.
Wow.
So I was on track to clear well into the six figures this year at the beginning of the year.
Right.
I had corporate speaking engagements. I had corporate contracts secured to coach leaders of all these companies. And in the period of 10 days, companies canceled all of their speaking engagements. Therefore, they canceled me. All the conferences I was paid to speak at, that got canceled too. So that canceled me. And then the corporate contracts that I had for coaching men and women, they were laying off employees, which means they lay off contractors. And that was also me. So, you know,
holy cow.
Yeah, 80% of my, 80 to 90% gone. So what did I do? I had a massive pity party, which included like 2 weeks. I mean, let's just be honest, right? I mean, like, you're like, holy shit, how am I supposed to just like keep going? I thought I was going to be making great money, and now I'm making no money. And I had, you know, the massive pity party for myself and figured out, oh my God, what the hell am I going to do? But I had like this aha moment where I'm like, wait a minute, like nothing can get any worse. So if I'm going to rebuild my business, like I have nothing to lose. I have absolutely nothing to lose. So I'm going to focus rebuilding it on the clients that I want to have. I want to build the business that I want. And my mission is to help women advance to the rooms where decisions are made.
Yes.
And it's also right about the time, because I love Hamilton. So I'm like, I'm going to make a room where it happens, you know? Plus I already was like, you know, I love RBG's quote. This was before she was, obviously all her quotes were made famous about women belong in all places where the decisions are made. And it was also right about the time where Susan was running Miracle Week. And so I'm like, okay, perfect. And I'm always all in on all of your stuff anyways, and have been for some time. But like something that you did in Miracle Week was so impactful for me. And we also did this exercise again and on the six, which again, it should be revisited every quarter, where she has you make a coat of arms for your business. And it was the time for me where I could get really clear about what I stood for. Mm-hmm. So to quote Hamilton again, like if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, I need to get clear on what I believe, what my mission is, who I support, and what I'm going to advocate for, and how I'm going to show up in the world. And I made the decision that I was like, I have to do this because it's not just important for me and my family and my mission and my values, but somebody out there is counting on this. So I just decided that I was like, I'm going to go all in. My word of the year was align. And a line for me was actually just like saying no to so many things so I could go all in on my mission. And, you know, then I eventually, you know, joined on the six. I stopped apologizing for only talking to women. I stopped caring if I was going to alienate some of the men that had followed me in my LinkedIn or in my news feeds or whatever that was. And as we started on the six, I don't remember exactly what you said, Susan, but it was just even something to the effect of like, how conscious are you about asking for things? So I was like, all right, I'm going to take my little crest and how I run my business, and I'm going to be clear about exactly what I'm asking for and who I'm asking to do business with. And so as the year has kind of turned around, I've, because I've gotten so clear on my message and so clear on who I'm talking to, I filled my largest group program ever. I doubled my one-to-one prices and sold my first signature coaching program. Corporate companies started to come back in and say, hey, by the way, we're actually like rolling again. Can you come and do leadership training for us? And you guys, this is the hardest part. I had to say no to that money. Because it was my old business model. And I'm like, if I say yes to that, I'm just rebuilding what I don't want. So I said no, and here's actually how my business has shifted, and here's what I'm working towards. And I was shocked because people were like, oh, well, we actually know somebody who needs that, or we actually have a program like that here. Go ahead and send me over your programs and your rates so we can consider to put you in our schedule. I booked a paid keynote at a women's leadership conference next year because, again, I was advocating, and I actually got a request for another keynote next year just 2 days ago. So, like, all of just going all in on my message and saying no to the wrong things has really helped me live kind of my word of the year, which is align.
I'm like sweating. Anybody else? I mean, like, when I get excited, I start sweating. I'm like, we gotta have emojis. Like, all, like, oh my God, you did all the things. Okay, sorry, go ahead.
No, I'm just going. That's just my bottom line. It's just like, it's really hard to say no to things, but I think something else, I believe that you said it in one of our calls, which was when you commit to going all in and putting exactly what you're trying to create in the world, in the universe, you will say no to some things, but like it conspires to help you. Mm-hmm. And I have no idea, like Lachelle was talking yesterday about the how, but I just trust that if I could continue to put the energy into the universe of what I'm trying to create and live my business mission, that like it will work itself out. Just one
it
small
totally
break
will.
Step at a time.
You were like such an example of all of this that we're talking about. Like you hit, like, COVID kicked your ass, and then you're like, okay, it can't get worse. Let me do what I actually want to do. Right? Like it was really hard. Like, when we go through these things, right? Like when COVID hit and I'm like, okay, I gotta change all my live events. I gotta do, and it's like in that moment, neither one of us wanted to hear like, you'll be grateful. Like it's all happening for you. It was like, you want to punch people in the face, but it's true. Like, look, your business is reborn in the way that you want it to be reborn and better than ever. Mm-hmm. Like, congratulations. It takes courage and guts and resilience and mental fitness to do all those things. So we so appreciate you taking a minute to tell us about that, because the chat just lit up. People are so inspired and so grateful for you sharing that.